So here I am as a student, and the goal here is to show you how you can basically take a picture of your math work and then send it to your teacher so they can edit it and give you some feedback on it. So Mr. Quilter here sends you an assignment, and here is the actual directions. And so Mr. Quilter's on the line right now. So Mr. Quilter, you said they can either print it out or just rewrite it, right?
Sure, of course, definitely.
Beautiful. So whatever you want to do, print it out, rewrite it. But either way, you need to submit your math work. So I'm going to show you the cleanest way to do this. So let's just say that you don't feel like printing it out and you're just going to write it yourself. So what we're going to do is this. We're going to go ahead and add, and then we're going to hit Google Slides. Mm-hmm. And then once we're on Google Slides, it's going to create a brand new Google slide that has your name on it specifically for this assignment. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a picture of your math work right in there. So the easiest way to do this is just to simply go to your Insert, Image, and then Camera. And then from there, I'm going to go ahead and just hold up my math work and take a picture. Okay. And hit Insert. And I'd probably want to make it a little bigger for Mr. Quilter so he doesn't have to make it, you know, himself or edit it.
Thank you so much. Appreciate that.
And then you can either, then you can be done, honestly, and then just turn in your work. Or if there's somehow a couple pages of work, you can add another slide and add some more work and so on and so forth. So however you want to do it, that's the quickest way to add your picture. And then it's already on here, and then turn it in. And then your job is basically done. So then Mr. Quilter is going to show us real quick what he's going to do. He's going to edit it, and I'll show you how you can see your work.
All right. Thank you so much for turning that slideshow in. I am now able to see your work, and I see that you have 3 times 4 is 12, which is good. So I can now add in, you know, a box saying good. If we have 1 plus 5 is equal to 12, again, can make another box. Awesome. And then right here, if we have 4 minus 5 is equal to -3, I am able to then scribble and then say, hey, you know, not really, go back. And then I am able to see all of your work, which is great. So now from my end, I would then put in the grade, let's say it's a 90, and then I can hit return back to you. And I would return it to Mr. Niemis, returning. And now it has been returned to Mr. Niemis. So Mr. Niemis, if you want to then show them what it looks like on their side after it's been returned, that would be awesome.
You got it. All right, so I'm sharing there. So now again, I'm back on my side. It's been returned to me, which is great. So now if I click on the exact same assignment, I'll see all Mr. Quilter's feedback right there, which is great. And since it's returned to me, I can always edit and make any changes that I want to do. So this is the simplest way for you to submit your work. Mr. Quilter can give you feedback, and you can easily see all that feedback all in one place.